Hey guys, welcome to another Wahab Originals video. My name is Wahab and today we're going to be going through some of the most recent charity pickups I've done. So basically, sometimes I pick up stuff from car boot sales and then other times I pick up stuff from charity shops. You can find a couple of good deals there, just depends. You go check it out, see what happens. It's not always great. Not a lot of it has a lot of profit in it because a lot of charity shops now charge higher prices. It used to be good a few years ago when I used to do reselling before, but this is my journey back in. So I'm testing the waters, picking up some stuff from different places and see what I can find. I got my listings up on the screen so I can tell you what I've listed it for. I did my comp research before I listed, so it'll be in the region. If I remember specific prices, I will throw them out. Top left hand corner from where you're watching, getting my sides correct, should have a zero for what I've spent and zero for potential sales. That'll update as I go through the products. So let's get started. First up, let's start on one Smiggle bag. I call them iridescent bag. I've listed it online for £19.99, picked it up for £3.50 from local charity shop. Seen a couple of different listings on this, not too many. One was listed for £35 and one sold for £25. So I went at £19.99. I thought that's a decent price. Is the wings are a little bit bent and stuff, so you know, I thought I'd lower the price. There's a crease over here as well, so you know, bear in mind the condition, I went for £19.99. I think that's a fairly decent price. Next thing we're gonna look at is a Bop It Extreme. Tested, working. There you go. This I picked up for £1. It's already sold for £11.99 plus postage on top. All my prices are not including postage. I always charge for postage. So £11.99 from £1, done well on that one. Then we picked up some plushies, so I'll have a look at those. These are those Goodness Gang plushies. They used to sell really well, apparently. You know, I watched a few other YouTubers doing their car boot sales and all of that kind of stuff. So I knew that these were decent. And comps on this one showing him on his own going for about a tenner. This one wasn't doing too well, so I listed them as a pair instead of trying to sell them individually. And I've listed them at £11.99. So, you know, get a little bit of a deal on this one and I get rid of this one at the same time. They cost £1.50 and £1. So £2.50 all in. So all right, turn that into £11.99. It's not bad. Like I said, it's not a lot of profit once you start calculating fees and all that. And I've got a spreadsheet that does that for me. So it's not a lot of profit after you take that all into account. However, it gets a sale on the table and that's what we need. So that's what we're going to do. Another plushie we picked up is one of these. This is Yoohoo and Friends. This was, I think, £1. It's currently listed at £4.99. Does have a watcher, so maybe someone will pick that up. But that's what that one is. Again, I thought it might be worth a bit more, but it's not, unfortunately. This one was a bit of a better buy. This one's a Mr. Men. I think his name's Bumpy. Mr. Bump. Even Bumpy's the dinosaur from Jurassic Park. Anyway, Mr. Bump, I've listed him, or I picked him up for 50p, and he's been listed for £9.99. The Mr. Men stuff does all right. Seen a few sell for around that price. I'm not sure what size they were, though. But I've seen a mini one for £9.99 as well. So I've listed him £9.99. We'll see what happens with it. Happily take an offer, so we'll see where that goes. All my items listed do have best offer available, so we'll see when someone offers, then I tend to take them, providing it's making some money. Sealed brain box game. I think this was £1.50 as well. It's listed for £9.99. It's a sealed game. Sealed games tend to do well because people don't have to worry about bits missing. Now, this could be one that'll sit on the shelf for a little while, up until like the Christmas time, and then might sell. But £9.99, I thought was a decent price. There's a few open ones going for £6.99. Sealed one, £9.99. See how that does. Ah, sorry, forgot one plushie. We found this M&M's, M&M World even. Plushie with the football, etc. I think probably missed the season for the football, because the Euros might have sold quicker. But again, listed £9.99. Again, that was £1.50 from the charity shop. Then we found this cap. This is a Disneyland Paris cap. It's got all the main Disney characters, Mickey, Minnie, Pluto, Donald Duck, and Goofy. This was a quid, and I've listed this thing for $19.99. I saw some other ones go range from that $9.99 going all the way up to 35 quid, different caps. I didn't see this exact one listed, so we'll see what happens. Again, if it's a good offer, I'll take it. So we'll see where they end up. Then we're on to some media, which is the bits I picked up in the last couple of days. Really excited by this pickup, and probably the best pickup by far. This was £1, complete with the booklet, in really, really nice condition. The case is in really nice condition as well. There's only one little crack in the top. Normally you find these cases, and unless it's been with a collector, they tend to be pretty bad. So this was only £1. I've currently got it listed for £24.99, I believe. Let me just scroll up here. Let's have a quick look. I can't see it. Yes, £24.99 is what it's listed for. That's what I hope to get for it. But again, offers, bring them in and I'll probably take it, to be honest with you, because I've only got a quid in. Bit of money is better than no money, right? So I want to, what I'm doing at the moment is try to find those good profit items, of course, but really I just want to get sales rolling through the door, make a little bit of profit. I'm happy with that. Just build up the following and sales and that momentum and let that go. So again, I'll take a good offer on that. That was £1 to £24.99 potentially. Always have my eye out for sealed media, even though it's not something I'd normally buy. So this disc, if I'd seen it on its own, I wouldn't have bought it. But as it was sealed, I thought I'd give it a punt. So this is a sealed John Barry, the collection, 40 years of film music. It's got a few different soundtracks on here, a lot of Bond kind of stuff, King Kong, Robin and Batman, Robin and Marion, not Batman, sorry. What else we got here? From Russia with Love, again, more Bond stuff. That was only £1. However, looking at comps, it's anywhere from £4.99 to £24.99, depending on the seller, I guess. I don't know what the difference is, really. For a sealed one, I did see £24.99. I thought that was a bit much, so I've listed it for £14.99. Again, offer, hey, great, I'll take it. I think £9.99 is probably about reasonable for a sealed copy, which is what, they have multiple, four discs in there. That'd be decent. But yeah, that was a quid as well. And this was Downton Abbey season 1, again sealed in the cellophane. That was £40p even, and I've listed that for £9.99. Sealed media is a no-brainer to me. It might sit for a while, of course, but it's sealed, so, and I've got a quid in it, or less than a quid in it, so why not? Another sealed piece of media, the in-betweeners seasons 1, 2, and 3 sealed DVD box set. That was £1, and I've put it on $7.99. There seems to be a few of these flying around, so not as much. There's more comps. I mean, people are selling them at different prices. Obviously, a used one's going for $4.99, so I thought a sealed one, $7.99, is pretty decent. So that's what I put it on at. And then for the final charity shop find for this round, we'll see how we go. Civilization 3 big box, PC complete with the booklets, the discs in mint condition. That was £1 at charity shop. And actually, this charity shop, it was funny, there was a lot of games there that I should have really picked up, but as I was browsing, another lady comes along, picks up like 3 games straight out the pile, and I'm just like, ah, damn, I must have missed some good stuff in there. Doesn't matter. Anyway, I looked at the rest of them. Civilization was probably the best one there, so I picked that up. Yeah, big box game. So that was £1, and I've currently got that listed at $19.99. There were some different ones, not the big box ones, going for different prices. I can't remember off the top of my head, but I tried to stay competitive and I tried to go middle of the range on my pricing. So $19.99 is what I've gone for, because it's in really good condition. Even the box itself is not bad at all, considering it's a fairly old game. Yeah, that's what it is. It's a game. This was, well, it says compatible with Windows 95, 98, ME, 2000, and XP. So, because it's got XP in there, I'd say that's probably, what, 2004, 5, maybe. But yeah, decent game. That's 20 years ago. 20 years ago. Doesn't feel like it, but it's 20 years ago. So, for someone to keep that in good nick for 20 years, I think it's worth $19.99. Anyway, that's all the charity shop pickups so far in this round anyway. I keep browsing, but I don't know. I mean, to be fair, like, the prices I paid is what I would have paid at a car boot, so I can't really complain about the margin. It is what it is. Is it worth it? Yeah, I think it's going to become more important in the winter months when the car boots are off. That and doing a browse on Facebook Marketplace for the odd thing that gets listed cheaply, which is very rare now. When I was doing reselling before, it was all, a lot of it was Facebook Marketplace, getting consoles and whatnot. But yeah, you know, some decent pickups. We'll see how it goes. You can see what I think I'm gonna make off all of this. Whether I will or not, we'll see about that. I'll do a sales video anyway, hoping to do one this weekend. So we'll see if some more of these charity shop things sold. If not, AO, that's fine. I don't mind sitting on stock for a little while, but really the aim is to flip through it so that I have momentum. I think it's a psychological thing more than anything else, if I'm honest. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching. Your recent support has been much appreciated. I'm making my journey back into the YouTube thing, back into the reselling thing. So, wish me well. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to subscribe and like the video and let your friends know about the video and get your grandma to subscribe. Whoever it is, get someone to subscribe. I'm on the road to 1,000 subscribers. I've been doing this YouTube thing since 2017. Obviously, it's been inconsistent. I've been out on and off doing the podcasting, whatever, you know, done a lot of things, but we can get some more subscribers. I want to get to the road to 1,000. So, you know anyone that'd be interested in this kind of content, tell them to subscribe. Thank you very much for watching. Take care. I'm out.